A few weeks ago, my building began installing smart radiator covers over all the steam heat radiators in the 76 apartments in my building. I was super curious about the tech inside and wanted to learn more. See, apartments in New York City with steam heat have a notorious problem for being overheated, and often opening the window is the only option because you can't individually control the radiators. This is terribly inefficient, but it's also a very complex problem to solve. I met with Marshall Cox, CEO of Radiator Labs, at their office in MetroTech Brooklyn.
Hi, my name is Marshall Cox. I'm the founder and CEO of Radiator Labs, and we are solving the overheating issue of steam-heated buildings.
He explained to me why it is this way and what his company is doing to fix it.
Essentially, all the buildings that have steam heat were built before World War II. They were amazingly well-built and really well-balanced, and so this problem that we have today where you're in your apartment, it's the middle of winter, and it's so high you have to open your window, that didn't happen back then. But what we did was we invented double pane insulating glass, and that totally changed the balance of buildings. And so you have to cater to the coldest apartment. Once that heats up to a minimum temperature, everyone else has gotten more or less vastly overheated. And that's why you have to open the windows. I mean, this is one of the biggest problems in real estate in New York and other big cities. The price of fuel is about 30% of the operating costs of a building. And so when you look at how real estate operates, I mean, they're one of the most efficient markets. In steam heated buildings, there's really not much out there to save energy. So when they find something like Radiator Labs, and we can show that we can make a huge difference, and not only that, but we can give people control over their temperatures for the first time in the history of the buildings. We can give them all these analytics on how their buildings are operating and show, you know, different areas for improvement. They're pretty excited about it. And so we've been running in a couple buildings for a little over 2 years, and we're seeing savings of between 24 and 34%.
Wow.
Yeah, so a lot of money. You can imagine an overheated room, and one way to make it not overheated is to close your valve, right? And so in ultimately, you have to reduce the amount of steam that's condensing in your radiator to reduce the amount of energy that's transferring into your room. And the way that we do it, as opposed to any kind of plumbing, is that we thermodynamically manipulate the condensation rate within steam within the radiator. So we do that by controlling the temperature of the air directly around the radiator. So if you're in a, I'll walk through a use case. So if you're in an overheated room historically and you put this cover on the radiator and the room starts out cold, the boiler turns on, the radiator gets hot, and our system senses that the radiator is warm and the room's cold, so it turns this fan on. And the fan pushes heat out into the room. And when the room hits the set point, the fan turns off. And when that happens, by virtue of the way that the cover is designed, we trap convection. And so hot air can't rise. And since it can't go anywhere, it just heats up hotter and hotter. And as it approaches steam temperature, 100 Celsius, the condensation rate of the steam inside drops. It's not going to go to zero, but it drops to some level whereby you have an equilibrium of energy that's leaking out of the cover and that's being replaced by the condensation. So that's how we do it. And we don't need any plumbing. You know, these are 100-year-old pipes, so that's a huge bonus. Obviously, we can dynamically control how much transfer is occurring. And another bonus is that every time we install one of these covers, we're creating an energy storage device in the room, right? A thermal battery, if you will. And so we reduce variability pretty significantly. This is a cover. We have a back that's also insulated. That just allows us to trap convection. And then this is the duct. There's a fan and a PCB module in here. It just pushes air up, and then that kind of mixes up here, and heat, hot air comes out the bottom and sheets out into the room. This is our thermistor. It's just a temperature sensor. This we couple to the radiator, and that tells us what radiator temperature is. So this is an infrared thermopile. It visually measures the temperature of the room, and visually is kind of a misnomer. It just can tell what remote temperature is. It's a single pixel.
And it's pointing at the wall.
It's pointing at the interior scene. And so, yeah.
My hunch was that the device that protruded up onto the wall was an antenna for the radio. It's not.
It's just a temperature sensor for the room.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nice. So it is capturing the whole room.
Yeah.
Oh, so I shouldn't put the curtain in front of it.
That's one of the ways they can defeat it, exactly.
Shoot!
Everything in here is pretty low tech, mm-hmm. right? We keep it low tech because we want it to, you know, not fail at a high rate, and we want it to last a long time.
And then what kind of microcontroller are you using here?
This is basically an Arduino with the stuff we don't need taken off.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, recreating this is trivial.
Right. Right, but it's not the magic in your business, and you have a patent on the idea of the radiator cover, but the IP isn't in the electrical engineering.
It's not, no. So the prototype I built in my apartment, you could build your own of this in a day. you need an Arduino, you need a thermistor of some sort, a temperature sensor of some sort, or two, and a fan, and then you need an insulated enclosure. And that's probably the hardest part, because don't use foil-faced bubble wrap, it melts. Don't use duct tape, because it smells like duct tape when it's hot. You have to find something that works well, and things that are fire hazards are fire hazards, so you have to be careful.
Ooh, you have like the super app. Get a load of that, Smokey.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if it shows where you live though.
Does it show my full address?
It says,
oh yeah, that's no good. We'll blur that out, it's fine. It's
you are 81% cozy. You're 18% warm.
What does that mean though, how percentage cozy I am?
It means that 81% of the day you're cozy. We also didn't
81% of the time it's like it's between a certain target temperature.
I think cozy is like 73 to 76 or something like that.
Cool.
So this is the whole building. So right now we're not, there's a 34% look like they aren't installed or not getting data.
Okay.
This is really cool because this shows us the histogram of the max temperature each radiator is getting. That's what it looks like when we're controlling the boiler. So temperatures are pretty perfect and then it drops down at night. What's interesting is that we have steam trap sensors. So this looks at the temperature before and after the steam trap, and a temperature differential of about 20 degrees indicates that's healthy. So we look at all the steam traps in the building, and when that differential drops to zero, or if something else weird happens, we know there's a problem and we can tell people to go fix it. And that's actually enormously valuable. This is something that they've never been able to do before. And a bone steam trap will waste about $400 a year in fuel.
In those buildings where I said we saved 24 to 34%, the set point was 75 degrees, which is way hotter than any of these people want to run their buildings. But it's not, you don't have to cool down the building to save energy. All you have to do is bring it down to a temperature at which people don't open their windows. And then you're saving outrageous amounts of energy. The biggest challenge for us is that every radiator is different size and shape. And we go into buildings and there might be 40 different SKUs. Right now we build every single cover custom. The thing that people hate the most is if you take space in their apartment that you don't need to take.
I learned a few things. The experience of urban steam heat wasn't always how it is today, and double pane glass is the main reason. The main components of the radiator cover are an Arduino-like chip, a temperature sensor, a fan, and an XB radio, plus a sheet metal shell with a heat-resistant insulating material inside. Each device is whitelisted, so security's pretty tight. The XBs mesh together in the whole building to make their own network that only talks to the outside internet through one location in the basement. Although I was reluctant to change the appearance of my gorgeous brand new cast iron radiators, the heat in my apartment is a lot more even now, and the radiator cover doubles as a shell. The extra bit attached to the wall is an optical temperature sensor, and it needs to be able to see the room to get an accurate reading. So I'll be moving this one so it's no longer obscured by the curtain. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed learning about these as much as I did. You can find out more information about Radiator Labs at the link in the description. Give this video a thumbs up if you've ever struggled with New York City steam heat, and don't forget to subscribe to catch my next video. I put out new how-tos every Monday and vlogs every Thursday.
I see. So I, what led me to believe that my, what led me to
I've actually not, I've seen someone else had, I literally have never seen someone else who had it since until now.
Downloaded it on Google Play.
Yep.